everyone. We are discussing relation and function. Our first lesson, we have already completed maximum of the topic. Just now we are discussing binary operation. In our last lecture, we have discussed binary operations. Now, in binary operations, we have discussed all the properties: commutative, second associative, third identity, and fourth one inverse. Okay, now we start with commutative. What is the definition we learn? That asterisk A cross A to A. Now, what is the relation of A comma B? You can write like this. So, what is its relation? A asterisk B equal to B asterisk A. This is called the commutative rule. Now, second again same associative. So, that is also you can do A comma B. Now, you remember when you write with A comma B, here associative means we are using three terms. So, A asterisk BC equal to A, B and C, that way. So, this is our second. Now, for identity also same way, A cross A to A. Now, if we get A with E equal to E with A. And if you get A, the same answer, you can say it is inverse. And last, sorry, identity element. Now, E is called the identity. Similar way, inverse. For inverse, again, same from A cross A to A. What is it? A and B related. And if you get identity element, or B and A, and if you get identity element, then A and B are inverse of each other. Now, how can you write A inverse equal to B? You can write, or A equal to B inverse also you can write, meaning remain same. Now, these all four properties we discuss with one example. So, first I wrote this much portion, and now we take one example in which we check all these properties. Suppose your example is, the relation is mentioned A plus B. Okay, now let's start with commutative. We are choosing two numbers, 2 and 3. So, 2 plus 3 is 5. Similar way, 3 and 2. So, 3 plus 2 equal to 5. So, both answers are same. So, you can say it is commutative. Now, for associative, let's take 2, 3 and 4. So, first you have to solve this 2. What is it? 2, 3 plus 4. So, 2, 7, 4 and 3. So, 2 plus 7 will be 9. Now, let's come to the second side, this portion, right hand side part, that A and B related with C. So, 2, 3 with 4. So, 2 plus 3 and here 4. 2 plus 3 is 5 and 4 means 5 plus 4. It's again 9. So, we can say both answers are same. So, associative also. Now, let's come to the third property. After completing, third one is identity element. Now, what is the condition for identity element? A asterisk E, this one, equal to A, equal to E and A. Now, let's take A plus E equal to A. We are just taking this much portion from both sides. So, E will be 0. Now, what we get? Is it true for this 2 or not? That also you have to check. So, A equal to E plus A, because A plus B is our property, E equal to again 0. Both way you get the same answer. So, what is your identity element? Identity element will be 0. Now, let's come to the inverse. how can we find inverse of it? So let's inverse the definition, this one. A asterisk B equal to E, and here your E is 0. So A plus B equal to 0, so B equal to minus A, or you can say A inverse equal to minus A. So in one example, I have shown all four properties which one we have already discussed. Now, main important thing for identity element and for inverse. See, we already learned in our previous classes, that is that for addition, 0 is the neutral number. So if you add 0 in any number, you get the same number, that is our property. But remember, when we are using this binary operation on n, then you cannot write 0 as a identity element, because 0 is not in n. Same way, suppose we are discussing on n only, and inverse we are finding. So A plus B equal to 0, so B equal to, you get minus A. Here also you cannot find in n, because in natural number we are not getting the negative number. So these two things you have to remember as far as these four properties concerned, especially in identity element and finding inverse of it. Now, I think we have discussed all the things of our chapter, and this last topic also, theoretical part is completed. So we start exercise for it. Exercise 1.4. Now check, determine whether or not each of the definition of binary operations in event asterisk which is given is not a binary operation, and give your justification. So question number one, it's first one. First one is given on Z. What is mentioned? That A and B is A minus B. Now let's check it. See, on Z given, if set is changed, then your answer of it is changed. Remember, don't do it by heart. Let's take 2 and 3. So if you take 2 and 3, 2 minus 3 is minus 1, which is in Z. Let's take 1 and 4. So 1 minus 4 is minus 3, which is also in Z. 2 and 1, so 2 minus 1 is 1, which is also in Z. So what is the meaning of it? If you get all the answers in Z only, so you can say it is a binary operation. So this one is the binary operation. But on place of, suppose Z, if you have given natural number, then it is not a binary operation. Why? Because negative numbers we are getting, which is not in N. So if it is asked in Z, it is a binary operation. But if it is asked on N, then it is not a binary operation. This is your question number one's first one. Now let's come to the second. What is your second question? A asterisk B equal to AB. And what is given? It is again on Z. Okay, so let's start. 1 and 2. 1 into 2, 2. Minus 1 and 2. So minus 1 into 2, minus 2. 3 and 4. So 3 into 4, 12. And so on. So you get all the integers. If you choose integers, you get all the integers. But remember, A into B, what you have to check? Binary operation, if it is given, then you have to check, is it a binary operation? In previous one, what we have? A asterisk B equal to A minus B. So for negative numbers, what we have decided? If Z plus is given, what is the meaning of Z plus? Here only Z given, so we are getting all. But here Z plus given. We have discussed with Z also, we have discussed with N also. But Z plus means what? 0 is there, but negative numbers are not there. So if only Z plus we are taking, this is not binary. Our first question, in that, if only Z given, first we discuss for Z. In your textbook, which question is asked? Z plus. But in first we discuss z, for z it is binary operation, for natural number it is not a binary operation, and for z plus also it is not a binary operation. Here you check, only z given and all integers you are getting, so you can say it is a binary. So meaning clear, if you get which set is given, if you get all the answers in set only, it is a binary, otherwise it is not a binary operation. This is your second question. Now third one. Now in third question, AB square given on R. AB square. What is the meaning of AB square? Means you have to take second numbers square. All real numbers you can choose. So let's start first with 1. 1 and 2. So 1 into 2 square. So 1 into 4, you get 4. Same way 1 by 2. And 1 by 3. So let's take 1 by 2 and 1 by 3 square. So 1 by 2 into 1 by 9. So 1 by 18. It is again on R. Let's take minus number, minus 1 and 3. So minus 1 into 3 square is 9, minus 9, and you can go so on. So if you get AB square, here again you are getting all the numbers in R, and answer also we are getting natural numbers, rational and real and everything, integers and all. So it is again a binary operation. Now let's come to the next question. Your next question is A asterisk B on Z given and mod of A minus B given. Mod of A minus B means you have to take modulus. And in fifth question, this is your fourth one. And in fifth question, again on R given, no, fifth on Z plus. And this also on Z plus only given. And this is A asterisk B equal to A. This way. Okay, let's come first to this one. Only positive numbers you have to choose, and answer also must be a positive. So if you take minus 1, sorry, 1 and 2, what you get? 1 minus 2, minus 1, but if remove modulus, plus. If you get 2 and 3 or 2 and 1, 2 minus 1, it is 1, and that way you get all the numbers. So it is also binary. Here you are choosing positive number, 1 into 2, A means 1, first number only you have to choose, 2 and 3, so 2, 3 and 4, so 3, and so on. What is the meaning of it? It is also binary operation, this is also binary operation, because both is mentioned on Z plus. So first 5 questions of question number 1, it's clear that binary operation or not, because according to definition, when you check for binary operation, we get only first one, which is not a binary. Otherwise, remaining all 4, we get a binary operations. Okay, now on the base of the same thing, let's come to the next question. Second number, read the question. For each operation given below, whether a binary operation is commutative or not, we have to check commutative or not. Okay, so second question is first one. On Z, what we have to check? A asterisk B equal to A minus B. And for the second question, on Q, A asterisk B equal to AB plus 1. Now we have to check, is it commutative and associative or not? Okay, first for commutative and associative, let's write the rule. What is the commutative? A, B. And if you get B, A, both is same. And second, A, B and C. And A, B and C. If these two you get same answer for both sides, then you can say for here commutative and for this associative. So let's start with first commutative. What is the commutative property? Let's choose two numbers, 2 and 3. So 2 minus 3 will be minus 1. Similarly, let's take 3 and 2. 3 minus 2 will be 1. What is the meaning of it? Not commutative, because both answers are different. Let's check associative. A asterisk B and C. Similarly, AB and C. Okay, let's first 2, 3 and 4. That way we have choose the numbers here also. 2, 3 and 4. Okay, now 2 as it is. 3 minus 4. What is our question? 3 minus 4. What is it? 2 and minus 1. Okay, let's subtract again. Means 2 minus minus 1 will be 3. Minus minus plus. Same way. 2 minus 3 and 4. So, minus 1 and 4. Minus 1 minus 4. So, minus 5. Check, this answer is 3. This is minus 4. So, not associative. So, what we have derived? A asterisk B, B asterisk A, we both are not same. So, it is not a commutative. Here A into B, C, A, B and C, that way we have taken both the one. Here 3, here minus 5, both are not same. So, it is not associative. Here you can write 3 is not equal to minus 5. So, not associative. Similar way, let's come to this one. Okay, first commutative. A and B equal to B and A. That way we have to prove. So, how can you write? Let's take 2 and 3 again. So, 2 into 3 plus 1. 3 2s are 6 plus 1, 7. Similar way, 3 and 2. So, 3 into 2 plus 1. So, 6 plus 1, 7. Both answers are same. Therefore, you can say it is commutative. Okay, let's come to the associative. Okay, so 2 and 3, 4 we are taking. Same way, this 2 must be equal, 2 and 3 and 4. Okay, let's solve this first. AB means 3 into 4 plus 1. Now check, 4 3s are 12 and 1, 12 and 1, 13. So, 2 and 13, what is it? 2 into 13 plus 1, again the same rule, AB plus 1. So, 13 2s are 26 plus 1, that is 27. Same way, check here, 2 into 3 plus 1 and 4, 3 2s are 6 and 1, 7 and 4. Now again, 7 into 4 plus 1, so 7 4s are 28 plus 1. Means 29. Check, one answer is 27, another answer is 29. So, therefore, you can say not associative. So, in these two questions, we have discussed commutative or not and associative or not. So, I think this two question is enough for this class, and in next class, we will discuss the next question. So, for today, thank you very much.